They are sitting there, pumping shell after shell into the homes of Gazans. Gazans who I'm proud to call my friends. Gazans who are my students. Gazans who are suffering terror every day. And this didn't start last week. What we're seeing now is nothing new. It's the continuation of a low-level campaign of murder that goes on month by month, week by week, day by day. Hardly a week goes by when Israeli planes do not drop bombs on Gaza and kill innocent civilians who make normal life impossible. And Gazans who are bombed cannot rebuild their homes because there's a blockade of Gaza that says the building materials to repair homes cannot be brought in. If you try to bring a boat into Gaza, you will be rammed, you will be stopped, you will be arrested. Bringing in medicines is illegal under Israeli law. Bringing in crayons and exercise books for children is illegal under Israeli law. Israeli law is illegal under international law. Israel breaks international law every day. And Batsheva are part of this. Until Batsheva will denounce Israel's crimes, they should not appear on the stages of London, on the stages of any civilized city.
I sat down in my seat and the show began, the music began, the dancers were all twitching, everything was wonderful and my heart began to beat strongly and I thought, why am I afraid? There is nobody with a bullet pointed at my head. The roof is not going to come down on top of me. I have to think of my Palestinian, my Gazan brothers and sisters and all the friends that have no voice. And so the show went on, they did one song, the applause came, the music began quietly again, and I could just feel my heart racing, and I shouted out, look, Israel is a terror state. And I said, terror has no culture. And suddenly I could hear another chorus of people saying, free Palestine. The next thing was, people began, security guards began running up the aisles. They were saying, she's at the back, she's at the back. I was sitting at the top in the first circle. I stood up and a guard grabbed me by the arm, walked me out quite briskly, pushing me, but not hurting me. But he was, he was an agent of the enemy. I was walked down two lots of stairs, more or less being pushed, and the guards on the ground floor came running and were saying, it's just the one, it was the only one. And he said, no, there are more people up there as well. The next thing, photographs were being taken. I didn't know whether it was their security or who it was. And one of their theatre people came up and said, where did you get your ticket? Where is your ticket? I want your ticket. And I said, I threw it on the floor. And she said, I don't believe you. And I said, what do you not understand about the way I am speaking? I showed my ticket when I walked in. I have been in. I threw my ticket on the floor. And she kept looking at me and saying, I don't believe you. And I said, we have a communication problem on many levels.
In my own words, well, it's the first time I did something like that in London. And usually I do it.
Don't tell us.
I do it back in my country. In my Switzerland. Oh. So I was quite how they would react here, it's what, but basically it's the same reaction.
Don't worry,
so yeah, she said it all. I think it was great, because I know also that some more friends are still inside.